Hello students, today I'll be starting with question number 6 of exercise 8.3. Now question number 6 says, Arif took a loan of Rs 80,000 from a bank. If the rate of interest is 10% per annum, find the difference in amounts he would be paying after 1.5 years if the interest rates compounded annually and compounded half-yearly. So it is said that Arif took a loan of Rs 80,000, okay? And interest rate is 10% for the whole year. We will have to find the difference in amount he would be paying after 1.5 years if the interest is compounded annually and compounded half yearly. Okay, so let us find if the interest is compounded annually. Okay, now what is given? Principal is Rs 80,000. Rate of interest is 10%, okay, and time is given 1.5 years. So if the interest is compounded annually, then rate of interest and time remains same. So the formula for finding amount is A is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 is raised to the power n. Now here P is 80,000 into 1 plus R is 10. So 10 divided by 100. Now in place of time, we can only put the whole number, because in this formula, we can put only the whole number in place of time. So that means we can, using this formula, we can find only the amount for 1 year, okay? For another half year, interest will be added on this, okay? Now, so here will be 1. So we would be getting amount after 1 year. So 80,000 into 1 plus 10 by 100 can be converted into reduced form. So 0 cancel. So we have got 1 by 10 is raised to the power 1. So 80,000. Here nothing means 1. So 10 into 1 is 10, is the LCM. So 10 divided 1 by 1 is 10. 10 into numerator is 10. Plus 10 divided by 10 is 1. 1 into 1 is 1. Is raised to the power 1. So it's 80,000 into 11 by 10 is raised to the power 1. Since power is 1, so we will write 1 time. Okay, so 80,000 multiplied by 11 by 10. So we'll cancel the zeros. Now, 11 8s are 88. And how many zeros? 1, 2, 3 zeros. So it's 88,000. Okay, so if we take 80,000, then after 1 year, he would be paying 88,000 rupees. Okay. Now we will have to find that how much he would be paying after 1.5 years, okay? So now interest will be imposed on this amount for another half year, okay? And for that we'll be using SI, okay? So SI for half year. So it's P into R into T by 100. So here principal is this 88,000, okay? Rate of interest is 10 and time we are finding for half year, so it will be 1 by 2, and since in the denominator we have 100, so it is 100 multiplied by 2. So if you cancel zeros here, then we have 8800 divided by 2. So cutting by 2 now, 244s are 88 and two zeros were there. So it's 4400. So Rs 4400. So what will be the total amount? See, this is the amount he would be paying after 1 year, which is 88,000. And on this, interest is charged, which is Rs 4,400 for another half year. So if you add this, we would get 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 8 is 12, 1 carry, 8 plus 1, 9. So it's 92,400 rupees. So if the interest is compounded annually, then he would have to pay rupees 92,400 for 1.5 years if he takes a loan of rupees 80,000. Okay. Now in the next part, we have to find if he takes a loan of rupees 80,000 and rate of interest is 10%, what he would be paying after 1.5 years if the interest is compounded half yearly. Okay. So here principal, rate of interest and time it's will remain same. So principal is 80,000, rate of interest is 10% and time is given 1.5 year. Now since here interest is compounded half yearly, so rate of interest will be divided by 2. So it will be 5% per half year. Now what would be the time? Here half yearly means in 1 year it is interest is charged twice. That means in 1 year if it is charged twice, then in 2 years it will be charged 4 times, in 3 years it will be charged 6 times. So interest, that means it is getting double, isn't it? So always time will be double in case of if the interest is compounded half yearly. So 1 by 2 can be written as 2 ones are 2, 2 plus 1 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 will be multiplied by 2. So 2 cancel, 3 half year, okay. So amount is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 raised to the power N. So P is 80,000 into 1 plus R is 5 and 5 by 100 is raised to the power N, N is 3, okay. Now this 5 by 100 can be converted into reduced form. So 5 ones are 5, 5 20s are 100. So 80,000 into 1 plus 1 by 20 is raised to the power 3. Now 80,000 into, we'll find the LCM, so 20 into 1 is 20. Then 20 divided by 1 is 20, 20 into 1 is 20, plus 20 divided by 20 is 1, 1 into 1, 1 is raised to the power 3. Now 80,000 into 20 plus 1 is 21 by 20 is raised to the power 3. Now 80,000 into, now 21 by 20 will write thrice as power is 3. So 21 by 20 into 21 by 20 into 21 by 20. Now 0 cancel, 0 cancel it, 0 cancel it. So 2 40s are 80, 2 20s are 40, 2 10s are 20. So in the numerator we have 10 into 21 into 21 into 21. Now 21 into 21 is 441. Now 441 multiplied by 21, 1 ones are 1, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4 into multiplying by 2, 2 ones are 2, 4 twos are 8, 4 twos are 8. So it's 1, 4 plus 2 6, 8 plus 4 12, 2 1 carry, 8 plus 1 9. So 10 multiplied by 9 2 6 1. So since there is 1 0, so 9 2 6 1 0. Okay, so it's rupees 92,610. So this is the amount which he would be paying after 1.5 years if the interest rate is compounded half yearly. Now we will have to find the difference in amount. Okay, now so if the interest rate is compounded annually, then he has to pay rupees 92,400 after 1.5 year, And if the interest is compounded half yearly, then he has to pay ₹92,610. So what we have observed that if the interest is compounded half yearly, then he has to pay more. So what will be the difference? Is since 92,610 is greater, so we'll write this one at first, minus 92,400. So if you subtract this 92,610 minus 92,400, it'll get 0 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 1, 0 is 1, 6 minus 4 is 2. So it's ₹210. Okay. So what we have observed that if we take a loan of ₹80,000, then after 1.5 years, if the interest rate is compounded annually, he would have to pay 92,400. Whereas if the interest is compounded half yearly on the same amount, he would be paying more, which is 92,610. And how much more? It's ₹210. Okay. So this was all about question number 6. Thank you, students.